you're going to get beat, 48-1 is the way to do it. Oh my God, what kind of a mile is that on a 5/8 mile track? That track is fast. Lord. Oh, we saw it earlier in the program, a haunted house winning 50-2. You know, it was funny. You know, when an older horse, 7, 8, 9 years old, stops doing something, it's a clear indicator that, especially a horse that's on a roll and has done it when he's been on a roll and then stops doing something, it's a clear indicator they're just not not on the top of their game, right? And Mark Beckwith had brought it up last week, and I noticed it. Everybody noticed it, but a couple of our clients also noticed it. Is that Patrick, his last two or three starts, didn't throw his head. Remember he used to always root his head. He didn't do it. Gary brought it up. Matt did. A number of people did. The reason I bring it up is because I tuned in just as they're going behind the gate, just in time to see Patrick throwing his head. And if he had been able to get away in the two-hole, I don't think he beats that moonshine horse. My God, is that thing on a heater right now? Holy God. 26, 54, 121, and then just steamrolls them. Man, did he look good. But if we get away in the two-hole, he might have been second. I'd say he probably was going to be second. He raced good where he was. You know, come 26-4, a mile and 48-4. Best mile of his life on paper. And look really, really good doing it. So, a great job by Mark and Melissa to get him back going. You know, this was not the horse of last week, and he won. That horse was a winner last week, Patrick. But he wasn't nearly as good as he was today. And it's nice to see him coming back alive. You know, it's a good lesson for everybody out there, is that there's nothing you can do to just turn a horse back on. When they're down in a funk or they're just not 100%, time, repetition. You know, we talked about it in an earlier video. You know, work. And although Patrick doesn't like to work very much, he certainly likes to work in the race. And has been such a good horse for us. And it's just so nice to see him come back to life and, you know, go a very Patrick-like mile. And then earlier, at the exact same time almost, Five Fish Species raced. I believe they called her second. She looked like she was second. I thought she raced really well. Short field and a maiden at Yonkers, but I thought she raced really, really well. Megan and Scotty doing a great job with her also. So, I give you a big, long video. Talked about how the day went. These were the two horses that were left to race. Second and a third, we'll take it. Five Fish Species raced great. And Patrick, the Piranha A, with a huge mile. Third in 148-1, paced 148-4. So that's it. I'm punching out for the night. All done. I'm about 2 hours from home. And got to get up tomorrow. We got a great bet to qualify. I got some horses to train at the track. We have our first Ontario two-year-old starting on Tuesday with Lonely Lakewood. And Ready for Landing. Oh, I drew the dreaded rail with Ready for Landing. Not where I wanted to leave from at all. Whew. We'll see how that works out. Lonely Lakewood, James called, said he couldn't drive him. He's going to go with the Walner colt of Desiree Jones's. At least I got a call. He was pretty angry at me earlier. Jody Jameson's going to drive Lonely Lakewood. And a good prep for his two-year-old season. More of just a race for Ready for Landing. Interested, excited, but also he just gives me the... He's a little bit like Grantini, right? He may not be. You know, he hasn't been the last 3 weeks. He is in the regard of, if he trained 100 times, he run 80 or 85 of them in his life. Yeah, very similar. Yep, very similar horses. But I don't get that feeling from Ready for Landing anymore now. I don't want to jinx myself. But I felt that he's school good, he qualified good, and he's coming insane. So, let's see how he does. Anyway, that's it for me tonight. As I said in an earlier video, the Gollies team is winning, so that's good. As I said in an earlier video, I hope you guys had a great day, because it was a good day at the stable, aside from little shoes, but that's okay. That's all mechanics. We'll get to the bottom of that. I talked to Tim for a little while, But shoeing with Pull the Shoe is what I thought would work with her. His biggest job right now is to continue to keep her eating and feeling good, and the rest will come. You likely won't see her Indigo next week. If we do have a PA horse, it'll likely be Royal Emeralds or one of our other Pennsylvania horses. But we'll see. We'll see how it plays out. So with that, I'm going to let you guys go. Take the rest of the evening off, why don't you?